This is Josiah Plays Divinity Original Sin 2. Alright, so we're gonna go, I guess. Oh, yeah, we're gonna look at our journal real quick. So I don't know what we're supposed to do next on this one. Oh, yeah. Find Zaliskar in the Hollow Marshes. Escape from Reaper's Eye. Beast's thing. Let's go to Driftwood. Fane's thing. We need to find someone named Niles under the fort. Losa's thing. We need to go to Driftwood. Sabeel's thing. We need to find Zaliskar in Hollow Marshes again. Red Prince. We need to find Bahara in the Hollow Marshes. Tell him Madame Zur sent us. Or go to a hideout in another part of Reaper's Eye beyond Fort Joy. There's a place where we may be safe. There's some people that managed to escape. We gotta get the phylactery of Lord Withermore on the main castle floor. Russia has some good folk songs, like Here's the Male Troika Rushing. Right. Boss link to the USSR national anthem. Katushia is a Russian folk song. Okay. This is a lot of stuff that I never knew I needed to know. We met and pickpocketed a Madden Delt named Virtus. Speak with the tortured sorcerer, which we did. Gotta figure out what's going on. What are we doing with Sahela? I don't know. Gotta figure out how to get Nabora to be willing to remove our source collars. We gotta find Irma. We haven't found any sign of Irma yet. Assuming Boss is doing all this as he is seeking to take over Anonymous's old portfolio now that his seat is empty. Ah. Makes sense. We need to find this other dog named Emmy. We need to fight in the arena in Fort Joy and try not to get owned. We might be able to beat that fight now, actually. Since we beat those magisters just now, I think we might actually be able to beat the fight in the arena. Gawain wants to meet us at a quiet alcove. Maybe I should go meet Gawain and see what happens. Withermore's secret switch, main courtyard of Fort Joy. Oh yeah, we already know. That's where we are. We need to get to the main castle floor, apparently. Hidden vault. Man, I have so many things to do. Okay, I still can't go out this way. Do you know what I can do, though? Watch this. I can't go through this door to get over here, right? But what I can do is just travel to this waypoint right here. Now, it doesn't work the other way around, unfortunately. I can't waypoint travel back into this dungeon. I'd have to go all the way around the whole pain in the ass way. I do want to see what happens if we go meet Gawain. I think I'll wait one more level up. Once we hit level 4, I'll go try to fight the arena again. Alright, we're back to... Oh, dead Elodie. No. I wonder if there's anybody that we should be going back to and trying to talk to a second time. Let's talk to Nabora again. Maybe we can sell her some stuff and maybe we can talk to her about removing the collars again.
The woman looks up as you approach, wiping her brow with a grease-blackened hand.
What do you need?
I have a few questions about Dallas.
The hammer got you curious. Yeah, funny name for a gal like that. When I knew her, The Feather would have been a likelier name.
Was it Dallas who invented these god's awful collars?
She nods once.
Clever lass, her. No wonder what Alexander sees in her. Question is, what she sees in him.
But are you a member of Dallas?
Oh, I don't know. She was a sweet soul. Quiet. Loved her family. Always seemed strong, as I recall, but she didn't come across as no fearless military leader back then. She was just a girl. People do change, don't they?
Let me see your wares. Apparently I can't talk to her about the removing the collar right now.
Get an eyeful.
She does have a lot of gold, though. She does have a lot of gold, though. And some trapdis. Oh, those are expensive. Fuck. Alright, so let's offer all my wares, which are worth 383 gold. So let's get 383 gold from her and hit accept. Alright, cool. We've sold a bunch of junk. Goodbye. And then we can auto-sort. So that cleared out a bunch of crap from our inventory. And now we're up to 3,000 gold, which is pretty nice. Alright. Now that we've done that... I'm sorry, Elodie. I'm sorry. Let's go meet with... What is this guy all about?
The Divine Order's all that stands between you and a...
Oh, yeah, that asshole. Okay, whatever. I need to go back to this jackass. Who is waiting for us in here, I think, where we met Fane.
This way, in the back. Follow me.
Oh, there he is. Gawain. There's the chest that we magically teleported over from the waterfall. Alright, what's he want me to do now? Let me guess. I teleport him down there. There's a corpse of an elf down there, and then he just leaves me. But I don't understand how that's really a problem since I can just teleport myself down there too. He said it could only work with one person. I don't understand what this situation involves, but I'm gonna save. If I end up losing those fucking gloves, no fucking dice.
Perfect. Now, teleport me down to the ledge behind me near the tree stump. I'll bring you right after. Oh, we're almost free. Can you taste the ale? Oh, the scent of home.
See, I know this guy's lying to me. I don't think he can teleport me at all, because if he could, he would just teleport himself. Teleporter, press L to view. Oh, he's got some nice... Oops, I didn't mean to alt-tab. What I meant to do is switch to this character. I think I've already picked his pocket, though, so I'm not going to be able to do it again. Yeah. He wants me to teleport him down here by this tree trunk. Alright. What if instead of that, we just teleport ourselves?
Come on.
What if we just put Fane down there? And he comes over here to check out this tree trunk. Oh wait, no, we don't need to attack the tree trunk. And then from here, you should be able to easily teleport down. Oh, this is going to be a pain in the ass, though. She would have to teleport each one of us to this ledge. Then she would have to teleport each one of us down here, including herself. She can do it with herself, right? Oh, you can't teleport yourself. Okay, but she could send the gloves down to Fane. Now Fane's got the gloves. And Fane could now teleport her down, right? Yeah, okay. So we could do it pretty easy.
Quickly now. Come along.
We need to help Garwin teleport himself out of full joy.
Alright, we'll do that. I don't trust this guy, though. Send a fawn down there, too. Now we're wounded, so we'll use the bedrolls.
Hey, over here!
Alright, let's send him down there and see what happens, but what happens if you teleport to a place where something else is, like a fly or something?
Over here.
It probably just fails. You probably are not allowed to teleport somewhere where something else is. How do we go into combat mode? How do we go into combat mode? Tab. All right. Let's send him down there.
Towards me. I'll teleport you down. I just need to see you clearly. Come close to the edge as you can, friend. Simply perfect.
Oh, it's working.
Now, teleport me to that mossy rock across the gulch, just by the torch. We're almost there.
That mossy rock. I mean, this giant rock covered with greenery? Alright, hold on. I need to get her first. The fly would probably end up in one of your stomachs, says Nox. Alright, let's see if we can send Fane over there. Sneaking failed? Who's over here? Or is it because of this asshole? This must be part of his vision cone, and that's why I can't sneak. Well, it looks like this is the way to freedom. I don't see any guards here or anything. Somebody right on the other side of this door, though.
Goodbye.
Magister. Oh, I did pick the lock.
You sully the Divine's name with this place. The Divine would want the world free of Void Woken.
Sorcerers are like the Divine's children. If you're harming them in here, we'll...
You'll do what? You're weak. Only we have the will to do what's necessary.
Wow.
I demand entry. You can't hide what you're doing forever.
This is nothing to do with the Paladins. Go and tell your Grandmaster that.
It's everything to do with the Paladins. You sully the Divine's name.
Violent, sure, but we can deal with them.
So this is where a whole bunch of assholes
if you're
are.
Harming them in here, we'll...
Magister Captain Triple.
You'll do what? You're weak. Only we have the will to do what's necessary. Goodbye.
This is what connects back to... Not here. Oh, this is a whole other courtyard. This is the other courtyard we could get into before. But doing so, we were in a bad situation where we were going to get caught. And we could, I guess, go from there through here.
Same as we did the black.
You'll do what? You're weak.
I need some way to, like, disguise myself as a magister so that I can walk through this area freely. And this looks like a dead end. Oh, but maybe there's a way to lower the drawbridge. No, I don't think so, because it's just like the last thing that we saw, where they're just going to stand there and repeat that conversation forever and ever. Until we walk up to them. But I don't know how to get to where we can freely walk through here, because if I go in here, we have drama. I need to close these doors, in fact. Now I can come down here to the docks, and probably this is where I would go to get away. But let's deal with this guy. Alright, Sabeel. Let's teleport Ifan over here. And then let's teleport. Can't teleport herself, right? Oh, she can Oh, I clicked on the wrong thing. I just healed myself instead of teleported. So teleportation, yeah, she can't teleport herself, but she could teleport Losa over there. And then, finally we teleport him over there. I have a feeling he's going to try to take off on us, and we're going to have to ace his ass for that. Let's see what happens. Teleport Gawain over here.
Even the air smells better here above that pit. Thanks for the help, and good luck getting yourself out.
See, going into combat mode does not automatically pause things. This dude's just out of here. Now he must have just ran afoul of a trap. What's he doing? What is he doing?
Hopefully the hammer is onto something.
Why are we involved in- No! What have you done, Gawain? You're about to get aced by a whole lot of magisters. I don't want to be part of this. Okay, alright. Let's just ease back on the fucking throttle here. We're just gonna let him go. He's about to go over and get killed by magisters. I'm not trying to get into a big fight with a bunch of magisters right now. Not until I can make sure that I actually have some chance to, like, maybe talk to them peacefully. I need to figure out a way to have permission to be in these restricted areas so I can walk around and talk to all these magisters and stuff. I mean, that might not be possible. You might literally have to fight them all, but... Alright, let's just teleport him over there. Let him do his thing.
Even the air smells better here above that pit. Thanks for the help, and good luck getting yourself out.
Got a lot of XP. It's just you and me, Stumpy. This tree trunk seems really important for some reason. What happens if I attack it? Well, I'm not damaging it with that attack.
There's no way off. There better be enough wood in that stump to make a ladder.
Oh, cool! It lets you make a ladder so you can get down to the beach below. Ah, that's awesome. Alright, hold on. Meanwhile, Fane, let's just take a little look here. This door has almost 5,000 health. We're just gonna take a little look-see. Oh, see, now they're over there fighting him. But I don't have to be involved now because the enemies don't know I'm here. He's getting his ass kicked. Silent Monk. See, I wouldn't want to be fighting all these. I could probably use this as some sort of really good distraction. I mean, obviously I can't just walk straight through the middle there. Well, I could. I could turn on invisibility and just... go wherever the fuck I want. Magister Knight is fucking this guy up. I wonder if... Oh, I see. I think I am supposed to use this as a time of distraction to get past these guys or something. I think they killed him.
Well, you know, not on purpose.
Not a chance. No
way. Where's the silent monks? Sure, you wanted to defeat. Oh, that's what what's-his-name was. He was one of these silent monks that had been... I've seen the etchings. What's-his-name? You can fake an etching. Jen asked when Dream Daddy would be. I told her he said it might not happen now. She is sending many messages. Well, I don't want to play it by myself. I want to do like a... dual stream or something. That would be more fun. Alright, so I don't know that I really want to go that way right now. He's disappointed in you. To murder some civilians or something. Sure. Okay. Let's get everybody together into a team here. Alright, Sabil, I'm gonna need you. Now there's a big old pile of poison right here. I need to burn that away. Hold on. So I'm gonna switch wands. Switch to this staff. Then I'm going to blast this poison. Then I'm gonna put that fire out. Then I'm going to switch back to... these. Oh, it brings the whole party down here. That's unexpected. Alright, so now we can look around down here a little bit. Oh, there's a cave! Oh, there's a fucking cave right here. Oh, there's dead bodies. Or at least one dead body. Corpse of an elf. This is where the treasure chest, and there's a rainbow. The treasure chest was here, but we already got it. Can't reach, can't reach, can't reach, can't reach, can't reach. Can't walk over here, can't walk over here. Alright, so now we have to go through the cave. Can we teleport ourselves back up there? Seems unlikely. Oh no, we can. We could go back. We could go back up with some teleporting if we wanted to. Alright, that's cool. Let's see what's on this corpse. Takes two to mangle. Oh, a disembodied hand. On the one hand, there's a lot to be said for picking disembodied limbs off the ground and stowing them in your rucksack. On the other hand, oh, there isn't one. See what they did, and some gold and a soggy note. The note, stiff with dried blood and river water, is crinkled and creased from being held tight in a dead elf's hand. Hold on. Teleporter closed.
We successfully teleported Gawain out of Fort Joy, but he abandoned us. We will have to find another way to escape.
I don't mind him abandoning us, honestly, because we still got the fucking... Ooh, look! I've completed 4 quests now. 4! In all these hours that I've played. Alright, so let's read the note. Soggy note.
These are my last words. I ask that one of my own kind, my own heart, reads them. Dear one, consume me and remember, I am not lost here forever. Maybe you leave, and you take me with you. Please.
See? Wants to be eaten. Wants to be eaten. Just out of curiosity, if I send this to Sabeel, and I send this to Sabeel, and I go to Sabeel, and I have her read the note, anything special happen? No. And I talk to Sabeel now.
Your eyes brim with inquiry, so ask.
Nothing right now.
Alright, she's gonna eat the hand, though.
You thought hard on the location of your fortune before passing. You wanted an elf to find it. You urge whoever tastes your flesh to go and enjoy what you cannot.
Oh, the note is some kind of clue to where this person's treasure. Jen says she'll do a joint stream with you. Alright, that'll be fun. Hasn't she already played Dream Daddy? I don't know how to find this treasure. Unless this treasure that was hidden up here in the waterfall was her treasure. She's not. Oh, I thought she had. Well, yeah, then tell her we should play it together with... Listen, here's what I think would be best. Jen can voice the main daddy, the protagonist, and the daughter, and I will voice all of the other daddies. That seems like it would work out pretty well. There's a variety of ways we could do it. I mean, we could set it up. I guess I have to go into this cave now. Well, I don't have to go into this cave. I can just waypoint travel. But Ah, maybe in the cavern is where her treasure is. Cavern hole.
I wasn't prepared for that. What now?
Wait, what? We're back in Zilix cell? How the fuck did we get to Zilix cell from that cavern hole?
Look at you, all enthused.
Yeah, we've talked to you before, Zilix. Like, what? How does that hole lead to here? Well, that's another way you could have gotten in here. So that's three different ways you could have gotten in here. So at this point, I've got a couple of options. I could... Jen accepts my proposal. Alright. How does she think would be the best way to do it? I mean, there's... It seems like there's a couple ways we could do it. We could both try to play the game at the same time and just make sure we're always on the exact same screen and we don't move on, you know, until the other person's done or whatever. We could also try to have one person play it and, like, do some sort of screen sharing thing with the other person. Because generally a screen sharing thing has a lot less delay than trying to watch somebody stream, you know what I mean? So that's another possibility. But I don't know how well that would actually work. And I don't really know what the screen sharing options are. I've never really tried to do something like this. But I've been wanting to do more joint sort of operations on my channel lately anyway. Okay. Well, we can go up to the middle layer of the prison. That's one of our options. Another one of our options is to try to sneak over there into that area where we just were. That's our two options, actually. I guess going to the middle layer of the prison is the best choice right now. Because I don't know of any other way to... I don't know of any other way to... I hear whips and people screaming in pain. Screen sharing? Yeah. Okay, so now we're in here, and we've got a silent monk. Now, I don't think he's automatically hostile. There's a rat we can talk to. There's another silent monk. So I don't know if these silent monks will automatically attack us or not. But here we've got... Oh, Emmy! Hey, that's the dog we're looking for! Alright, so I don't want to kill these dogs, because we're here to talk to one of them. There's a lot of silent monks. I'm not sure what will happen if and when they see us. Although I suspect they're not going to be amused. I don't want to butcher them either, because they're basically innocent. They didn't ask to be here. They've been lobotomized and forced into this sort of weird kind of slavery. I don't want to kill these dogs. Look, Birdie, it's whining in a little cage. I don't want to kill these dogs. And I don't want... Ooh, Houndmaster's crossbow. And I don't want to kill these monks if I can avoid it. So what we're going to do, I do want to talk to that rat. If I can talk to the rat first, we might get some useful information out of him. No, wrong character.
Do you hear that? It's coming from behind the wall. It's sort of eerie, like a poor soul in a glass trap. Oh, the horror.
Hmm. Okay. Behind the wall. Well, it doesn't really look like this guy seems to care that we exist. I guess. I want to talk to the rat again.
Do you hear that?
What if I try talking to this little fellow? Looks like he shops at Hot Topic. Okay, so they have no idea what's going on. She's done screen sharing before and knows how it works. Awesome! See, I knew Jen would know some shit. Ooh! Somebody in my party wants to talk to me about this situation.
The creature before you stares with sightless eyes and leans from side to side, like a puppet without strings.
I thought I'd seen the worst that life can offer. I was wrong.
That's an abomination, is what it is. I can't stop staring at it.
That's unnatural, abhorrent, evil. I can't take my eyes off it.
I think Sibyl secretly likes it.
It seems to be even more primitive than the rest of its species. Fascinating.
Thanks for your input, folks.
Is it not enough that you travel with? Go on then, bark away.
Hey. Hi. Ooh, so serious.
A moment's pause. I had thought it.
Okay, none of them have any special options. Sunday to Wednesday next week, and then again the Monday after for both this and D&D. Thanks for all that channeling you did, Saito. Well, maybe these dogs also won't attack. If I just walk up here all casual. Like I know what I'm doing. Oh, we better.
Those dogs sound out for blood.
All right, so if we send Losa first, she's the pet pal. Let me quick save. Yeah, Monday is my other D&D game. Hello. Buddy's key. Oh, the key we got from the dog. This is where we can use it. Oh, I can use the squeaky red ball that I got from the Houndmaster. Let's use the red ball.
Ball?
Ball!
Ball!
Throw the ball.
Bruno barks, beside himself with joy.
We leveled up from that? Are you serious? Finding Emmy is done.
We found Emmy, the dog that Buddy mentioned previously. We did what we could to help her.
Wait, we didn't help her? Hold on a minute. I feel like I skipped part of this quest.
Buddies. Buddy.
I feel like I need to do this a little bit differently. Yeah, plenty of blessings for. Thanks, Seto. Okay, man, I wrote a whole bunch more of my character's story for that today. And it starts getting hella creepy at this point. Like, not creepy in a good way, but creepy in a creepy way. You'll see. I'm gonna share it at some point. Maybe I'll wait for the whole thing to be done, or maybe I'll share just part of it. It ends on a really creepy part, though. If I shared it right now, it'd be bad. But you have to understand, this is the background of an evil character. I mean, he's... trying not to be evil now. He's trying to be redeemed, but he's still an evil character, so his background involves a lot of things that are not in keeping with traditional morality. Yeah, that was just like a little bit from the part that I wrote today that I just felt like throwing out there. Hello? Can I pick this lock?
Catch baddies. Buddy? Baddies. Baddies. Buddy.
I can. I don't get XP for that though, it doesn't look like. No, it's not supposed to be him. Fucked it up again. What time will the session be? Let's see. What time will the session be? I think it's 5 o'clock Pacific time on Monday. What is up, Sin? How you doing? Thanks for that host. Really appreciate it. How's it going, Sin?
You intruder!
There's Squint at the Hound called Emmy. Hey there! Do you know an old dog named Buddy?
Buddy?
Emmy! Fallback! Sorcerer! Trix! Buddy! Intruder!
Bruno! Buddy? Buddy! My mate? Hello?
Buddy misses you very, very much.
Buddy? My buddy. But work. Search. Sorceress? Why? Buddy?
Emmy, no! Sorcerer! Bad! Baddies! Bite! Rump! Rump!
Bruno, I miss my buddy.
Wait, you've been playing Total War Warhammer 2? There's a number 2? A number 2 Total War Warhammer? I didn't know that. I played the first one. Are the sack values higher in the sequel?
You, sorcerer, go! Emmy, crying!
Catch baddies!
Finding Emmy.
Baddies! Baddies! Buddy!
My tummy hurts.
Did what we could to help her, but we didn't help her. Apparently we made friends without using the ball that time. What happens if I run up here and try to talk to Bruno now?
Emmy, sad. Bad sorcerer.
Scratch, bite, bark, kill.
Let's just try this the other way. I want to see what happens if I use the ball. There could be sack values. It just came out. What race are you playing, Sin? Which ones are available in number 2 and which one are you playing? I played as Chaos. That's the only one that I did a full campaign of, was Chaos.
You intruder! Paul? Paul!
Bruno barks, beside himself with joy.
Alright, so that time we used the ball. Finding Emmy is closed. Hey look, we actually have completed 5 quests now. I'm so good at this game. Lizardmen, Skaven, High Elves, and Dark Elves. Really? It's got Elves this time, huh? And Skaven. Skaven are cool.
My tummy hurts.
Alright, we just leveled up. So I'm gonna save the game at this level point. We need to get some stuff. Alright, so we do not get another talent at this level, sadly. Or a civil ability? We don't get a civil ability? Are you fucking kidding me? It's been forever since I got a civil ability. Oh man, that means I don't get to upgrade persuasion and we don't get to upgrade thievery. That's upsetting. Alright, we get one of these and I don't know what to spend it on. And 2 of these. What kind of skills do people even want?
Brett. Just dust bunny.
You could have more warfare. Scratch, bite, bark, kill. Threw a red ball for the good little doggies. Yeah. Yours bugged out, Sin? Did you get the ball off of the corpse of the Houndmaster? Because I got the ball off the corpse of the Houndmaster, and then I just threw the ball to them just now.
Hello?
Brett?
Buddy's key.
Dust bunny.
Let's see. Now that I've leveled up, what about my skill panel? I do have an extra slot. That's good.
Catch baddies.
So for him...
Baddies! Baddies! Buddy!
Do I want him to learn Aerotherge, Pyrokinetic, Necromancer, Polymorph? He's already got Polymorph. Huntsman, he's already got Huntsman. Oh, he should learn Hydrosophist and get Restoration also.
Catch baddies. Buddy?
Oh, he needs some baddies. Geomancer.
Baddies?
That's what he Buddy? Needs, and then we could get some Geomancer books. Did, but they didn't do anything? Oh, that sucks, Sin. Well, did you already have the quest from talking to the other dog up in the town? Did you have somebody with Pet Pal? What does Fane want in his life? Got some good polymorph, some more scoundrel probably.
This can't be it.
I don't think Fane really needs any of these other things.
Dust bunny!
My tummy hurts.
This rat.
Now Losa, she should get some Hydrosophist. I mean, I could keep going in all in on summoning with her. And just do like nothing but summoning with her. But then if I do...
This can't be it.
She's got mad memory slots that she needs to put things in. And no skills to put them in. So maybe I could give her like... Maybe I could give her Oh, that's right. I was going to give her necromancy. I should see if this bloated corpse. That's what I was going to do. I was going to test. I'm still in Act 1. Yeah.
Hello?
You're on Act 4? Wow, I didn't even know there were that many acts. That's a lot of acts. Okay. What I want to know is, can I summon my thing and summon a bloated corpse? Can I summon my incarnate and a zombie at the same time? Okay, where's my corpses at? Here's a corpse. So, let's just say hypothetically that she did learn necromancy. And then she did learn to raise a bloated corpse. Now, can she raise a bloated corpse? Oh, look at this thing. And then also summon an incarnate. Nope, she can only have one or the other. Alright, well that's super lame then. Okay. I don't think I'm gonna bother to have her learn necromancy right now then. But somebody else could learn necromancy. Like Sabiel. Can only have one summon. Sin, can you only have one summon per party member? Or can you only have one summon for your entire team? It's gotta be per party member, right? Your minion dies, it takes ages for the cooldown. good point.
Brett.
I might give necromancy to Fane because he'll heal for damage dealt. He could always use more ways to heal. Plus, then he can get Bloodsucker to heal himself some more as well. Your entire team can have one minion summoned per person. So one summon each, you're saying. Somebody's gonna take some fire magic. She's only got one slot available. Maybe I'll give fire magic to this guy. No, I want to give geomancy to this guy. I forgot. I just don't have any geomancy books yet. Where do I get geomancy books? Somebody in this fucking place sells geomancy books, and I don't know who it is. Somebody does. We'll figure it out. We'll figure out who has the geomancy. It's not him. It's not him. It's not them. If all of you summon an incarnate, you could outnumber some fights. Oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah, incarnates are pretty awesome so far. There was a guy that was a merchant. Oh man, I hope fucking what's his name wasn't the geomancer guy. The dude that we just got rid of. Baladir is not the geomancer. Hilda might be. She's a traitor.
Still on your feet, eh? Glad to hear it. Feel free to take a gander at the store.
She's got scoundrel books. Oh, she's got some good new stuff. Hold on. Hildur's plate. Wait a minute. Oh, I think just because we leveled up, we hit some kind of new... I think we hit some kind of new tier of items. I wonder if I can pickpocket her again. Probably not. Seriously. I just want to know if I can pickpocket her. No, it won't let me. I think I have to raise my thievery or something. Geomancer, check the campfire. There's a dude there who sell it. The camp... Oh, that dwarf woman? Or whatever? Anyway, people have new stuff, so I kind of need to go check all of the adrenaline.
I'll be with you soon, love.
Chloroform, cloak and dagger. Teleport without breaking, sneaking. Oh, I want that for Fane. Rupture tendons. That looks really good for Fane also. Sawtooth knife pierces physical armor and directly... Oh... Oh, but these are expensive. I don't have any wares. Every time you level up, new items appear in the stores. Everything scales up to your level, so it's better to save your thieving until you actually need it. You can only thieve once per person. Even if you raise your thievery later, you can still only thieve once per person? Because, man, I didn't realize that. I stole from everybody already. Skill books are about to take all my fucking money. Hmm. When do you start getting a lot of loot that you can sell and stuff? Because so far I've gotten very, very, very little. Alright, so Hilda's got scoundrel books. Down here there's some other people that sell some other stuff. Mayall, he sells stuff.
Do you find a use for that rope, my friend? I am sure it helps.
Here's Geomancer. So what does he have that my fighter might want? Fortify. Fortify is something my fighter would want. Mend metal. Poison dart. Worm tremor. Impalement. Fossil strike. Alright, we should get fortify from my main guy. Well, before I do that, I should check and see what the warfare vendor has. Better to steal money because you can buy stuff cheaper if you have a dude who is a barterer. Well, then you ain't been looking long. You can steal. Dude, I have stolen a lot of stuff, but I mean, like, it's all crap. I mean, I have 3,000 gold, and I'm still in the. Haven't even left the first area, but I mean, like, I mean, when you start getting, like, loot, like, magic items, dropping off enemies and stuff a bunch, like, that hasn't really been the case so far. Like, I remember in the first game, you get to the point where you're getting tons of loot, and you come back to town, and you've got mad stuff to sell. Does that happen in this game? Alright, hold on. Who's the guy that sells the warfare stuff? That's Beast over there. Your iPhone has geomancy? No, it doesn't. This woman's... Oh, this is Stingtail. He's dead. Oh, he was a vendor too, wasn't he? Wonder what Stingtail... Hey, I wonder if I can talk to Buddy now about his situation. Actually, let's not yet. I want to actually go in there and talk to those dogs.
Finally kicked the book at this and... Didn't think. All right, whatever. And
okay, she's got posts. Spread your wings! Oh my god! Yes! Medusa head. Petrifying visage. Heart of steel. Heart of steel is nice. Tentacle lash. Spread your wings. Alright, I need some polymorph stuff in my life. But I also need to see what the warfare options are. Could tell me where I'm on Earth, hence geomancy. Well, the geo part I'll agree with. I just won't agree with the mancy part. I don't know what mancy means exactly, but basically it implies magic. There's nothing magical about a phone. Trying to remember who. Oh, wait. Is it the lizard guy in the elf cave that sells warfare stuff? Let's go in the elf cave. Stink sells water spells. Oh, that's too bad because I would like to have more water spells. But he's dead. Callius sells something.
The soldier tightens his grip on his spear and looks past you.
Alright, he sells warfare. Okay. And he sells some, like, nice items and stuff. But I can't afford this shit, man. I can't afford this shit. I wouldn't mind having a better shield. Don't even have enough constitution for a better shield. Damn. All of this stuff is really expensive. Battering ram, bouncing shield, crippling blow, enrage, Battle Stomp, Provoke. Oh, Provoke could be really good for my warrior. Whirlwind. But it's resisted by physical armor. That's kind of garbage. Because you get into the fight and you want to provoke them and you can't because they all have a shit ton of armor. I feel like I can't afford things. Yeah, I'm not really trying to buy items. I'm just trying to buy books. I do have a lot of books here, but I don't really necessarily want them. I'm just gonna have people keep going in on the things that they've been. Oh, who's got summoning stuff? Who's got summoning stuff? Because there's Sahela, Rula. Because that's the thing. I want to keep going on summoning with Losa, but she's also got all these empty slots because I can't find any other summoning spells. Somebody has to sell summoning stuff. But I don't know who.
Food. Yum.
Maybe the lady in here, the disease lady?
She groans in pain, refusing or unable
to
acknowledge.
No, she sells necromancy. Death wish. In fact, somebody has summoning stuff. Combat skills have extra passive if you hover. Oh yeah, I do know about that, of course. Like the extra stat points that you get for putting points into polymorph, or the extra damage with weapons for warfare and stuff like that, and the extra healing that you get for necromancy, which makes necromancy kind of good for everybody.
The woman looks up as you approach, wiping her brow with a grease-blackened.
Oh, Nabora's the one with summoning stuff. Okay, what has she got? Dimensional bolt. Rallying Cry. Target character regenerates vitality and magic armor. Well, that's pretty cool. Conjure Incarnate. Power Infusion. Wow, Power Infusion. Supercharger. Elemental Totem. I just don't feel like I can afford a lot of these things. They're so expensive. Sin, how often do you get civil skills? Because it seems like I've never really gotten any beyond first level. At first level, we got our civil skills, and then now I'm up to level 4 and we still can't raise these. He's got a 1 sneaking, 1 thievery, and I can't raise these forever. And I've been trying to get telekinesis for her, but she still has never had a chance to get it ever since we first picked her up. We need more civil skills every 2 or 3 levels. Well,
right mind would think of a thing like this.
Dig up to max 5. How high level do you even go up to in this, Sin? What level are your characters? See, I did rob a bunch of skill books. That's why I have all these, basically. But I didn't realize that I wouldn't be able to steal from those people ever again, so I just stole whatever. Which obviously wasn't a good idea. But this is just the first little area, so I'll know better in the next area. Well, what level are your characters? I need to end this episode. If you're watching on YouTube, if you're watching on Twitch stream, don't go anywhere because I'm not done playing. You're like level 17? Wow. Okay. But if you're watching on YouTube, that's going to do it for this episode. So thank you for watching. This has been Josiah Plays Divinity Original Sin 2.